In this video, I'm going to talk about Manus AI, a really powerful new AI research agent that can go on the web for you, perform any kind of research, and deliver you really interesting results. I'm going to show some of the workflows that you can use in Manus in order to achieve really good results, and also demonstrate how you can use the InfraNodus knowledge graphs in order to extract some additional insights from Manus and resolve some of the issues it has, especially when the context of your research increases. So if you're interested, keep watching and I will show you how it works. Also, a little bit myself, I'm Dimitri, I'm the developer of InfraNodus, a visual AI text analysis tool, and I just share my insights about various AI tools on this channel. So if you like this video, please subscribe so that it can get recommended to other people. So let's dive right in. First of all, what is Manus? Manus is available on manus.im, and you can also use it on your phone. And basically it has this like basic chat interface, which you see right now on the screen, but you can give it tasks. And then what it does is that it performs a search. Here I have a search that it's performing. And basically it creates like a schedule of how it's going to respond to your query. And if it needs to browse the web, here you see it's already browsing something for 40 minutes. I gave it a really complicated task. So it's browsing the web for you. It's opening the browser windows. It extracts the insights and then it compiles them into files that can be a CSV file, like a table, or it can be also a report. Like I have, for example, here some report on the competitors of InfraNodus. So it can really deliver really interesting results in a very digestible form. And it takes usually 10 to 20 minutes to do that. And it's basically like having a research assistant. So the most interesting use case is when you need to perform a research to get like an overview of a certain topic, or when you needed to go on the web and to search through multiple websites and to extract some really specific insights and organize them in specific ways. This is what Manus is really good for. Some people also use it for coding. I don't like to use it for that so much because it gives you the files that you need to download on your local computer, so then you have to run it yourself. But actually, even if you need to do that, it offers a really nice result. So really it can be used for anything, but I like using it for research and marketing. Let me show you some of the workflows that I think work pretty well with Manus and how you can also combine it with InfraNodus in order to extract some of the insights from it. So basically, for example, here I have a research that is running and I will show you the initial prompt. This is something I learned from my friend Pedro, who has a company in AR and VR called Anicha. And basically he attaches a file with the list of competitors. So in this case, it's the competitors of InfraNodus. And then you ask it to prepare a list of their weaknesses and to provide an actionable summary of how they could be addressed by InfraNodus to lead in the market. So then you just upload the CSV file with the list of competitors for your product, and then it will ask you a few clarifying questions which you can answer, and then it departs on a long journey. It performs research, it studies all their websites, it also scours the web in order to find reviews for them, what people think about them, how well it works, and so on. And then finally it delivers results, and it's also telling you what it's doing, so that's really great. And then at some point of time, after 10 or 20 minutes, you will have a file like this, a report. Basically it will show you, look, I had this to-do list here, so it always shows you what instructions it actually followed, right? So you can see them here, what it did. And then it gives you some results, like for instance, the initial table, the table that it modified, then the summary of what you have to do, like the advice that it gives. The file I'm interested in is this analysis of the competitor weaknesses. So when I get that file, it's quite a long report, which would take me quite long to read. And this is where the problems actually of Manus start, because if you try to then make another iteration on top of that file, sometimes it just veers off the course and provides results that are not so precise. So this is where I like to use InfraNodus. And what I can do is basically download this file as a MD file, and then I go to InfraNodus and I import that file here, file upload. I choose that file which I downloaded, competitor weakness analysis, and then I click next. Here I choose that I want to analyze the file, and then click Visualize. And what InfraNodus does is that it visualizes this report that was generated by Manus as a knowledge graph. It shows me the main topics inside and how they're connected to one another. So I get like a really good overview of their weaknesses in this context, right? Because that was the original task. Here, I think it's talking about only visual data analysis tools. So then it gives me like an overview of the main topics, how they relate to one another. And then I can start asking InfraNodus questions about this. So I can either use the graph itself and see like, okay, it's talking about some limitations for users. For example, a steep learning curve, pricing limitations and so on. So this is one type or category of weaknesses that it found. Data insights, so for example, that other tools don't really provide so much capabilities to get insights from data. So this is something I could also address with InfraNodus. And then some other stuff like content mapping, and also here I have analytical management and so on, right? So there, what I can actually do is then use this knowledge graph structure in order to ask the AI to generate some interesting insights for me. Because if I go back to Manus and I try to do that inside Manus, it's going to be a little bit complicated because it's already like a pretty long file. It's going to take me very long to read it. And then if I start asking Manus, you know, can you give me a summary of the weaknesses? So this is something that you could also do, that the competitors of InfraNodus have according to your report. And then I can also specify the report to be more precise, weaknesses analysis here. It will go on and try to perform this task. But what I found, and what also a lot of people report on Reddit and on various forums, is that the longer you go, the worse it gets. So it's kind of good to get like a general overview, but then it's better if you do the work yourself. Also, it's going to take quite a long time to provide this report. And what I also don't like is that I don't really know if it's going to extract the stuff that are really relevant, because it's AI, it's very good in generating information, but I don't have any control of where it's actually looking in this document. And this is the problem I'm having, right? So here you see it's showing me what it's doing, which is good already. So I get some idea of where it's getting its insights from, but I feel it's a little bit of an overkill because it's too much data. I don't really get what's going on. Whereas in InfraNodus, when I upload it here, right, I can see directly what's going on, like what are the main topics or the topical clusters that relate to those weaknesses. So I can see that there's something about data insight, limitations, like I said before. And then I can start interacting with this graph using the built-in chat in InfraNodus. I need to make sure I switch on focus on this context. I get the responses from this context, and I can say, what are the weaknesses of InfraNodus competitors that it can capitalize on? And then it's going to use this context that was generated by this research agent, Manus, but it will then provide some nice results based on that graph structure. So it's going to be precise. I'm going to know that it's going to derive the insights from these main topical clusters and from these ideas. So it's not going to be a hallucination, but it's going to be a pretty nice and also quick overview of what I could do in relation to my competition in order to stand out and in order to address their weaknesses and to somehow offer a product that would be more interesting for my potential customers. So here it says, for instance, that there's a lot of different tools, but for instance, here it's talking about the ability of InfraNodus to provide deep insights into the structure and dynamics of complex texts. So this is something that all those network visualization tools don't offer. And then also how InfraNodus can be using AI for exploratory text analysis, addressing the gap left by platforms with a steep learning curve. So it's kind of making it easier for you to get the insights using the AI, something that other tools either don't offer or make too complicated, or maybe the quality is not good enough. And then also, of course, all the capabilities that it has, like the knowledge graph, the API, and so on. So it gives me like a nice summary or an overview of the advantages that I can focus on when I promote my tool in relation to my competition based on this research that Manus did. And then I can save it to notes. also make sure to favorite this graph so I don't lose it, and then I can keep on actually gathering more ideas, because now I can focus on one of the topics. So for example, if I want to learn more about data insight, I can select this topic in InfraNodus and ask it to summarize this topic for me. So I know exactly what's going on. You see, I'm directing the attention of AI on the particular elements of the report that Manus generated, and then I'm asking it to provide me insights on these topics. So I know what's going on, and it's much easier for me to also digest those insights because it's much clearer the information I'm getting. If I go back to Manus, it's actually still preparing the report, or maybe it prepared it already, and I can click on it here and see what the summary is like. And here it gives me also like a nice report, but I didn't have any control about where it got it from. I actually see it's mentioning some of the stuff that InfraNodus mentioned also, but as you can see, it took it much longer to do that. And also, it's always good to combine the insights from different tools so that you know that you're really getting like a more or less general picture. So this is why, like I said, one of the workflows I like to use Manus for is to launch the agent on this research of the web. Then it provides me a report. And then while I'm interacting with Manus, I'm also interacting with InfraNodus to get some interesting insights. And then the ability to use the graph to focus on specific concepts is quite interesting, because then I can be like, okay, what about, for example, the limitations that the users face? And then I click here and then I just focus on that topic. It would be harder for Manus to do this because the context is too long, and this is what the users of Manus report, that the longer it gets, the harder it becomes to focus on specific nuances, so to say. So this is like a workflow that you could use. And the easier way of doing it also is to actually just make a query, so you don't have to upload a table with the competitors. You can also just ask it to perform a research on your competition. So I think I have a window open here somewhere where I ask that. Maybe I can show you the other workflow I had. Yeah, so here I asked it to compile a list of the main competitors to InfraNodus, analyze their offers, and make a list of their weaknesses. So here I didn't need to seed it with the initial table. I just asked it to provide a list by itself, and that's quite interesting because then I rely on how it sees InfraNodus itself in order to generate the report and not on my biased view of it. And then it provides me some report. Then it gave me the files here. And then I said, okay, you are too focused on graph analysis and visualization tool, but I want you to also add text analysis tools, thinking tools, insight generation tools, qualitative analysis tools, so all the other stuff. So you see it kind of like it didn't do the full job well, but I gave it another prompt and then it went away for another hour, I think, which is pretty crazy, and it's still doing it. So as soon as it completes the report, and by the way, here you see how it's browsing the web and analyzing information, so it's pretty cool. I really like that you can see like how it's reading the web. But basically, as soon as I have this final report, I'm just going to use the same workflow as I showed you here. I will download that report and then I will ask InfraNodus to analyze it. And by the way, we also have a browser extension, so you can do it inside Manus itself. So if I click here on InfraNodus competitor features, for example, if I want to analyze the features, I could launch this extension here. I'm actually going to do it for the weaknesses of the competition. So let's see here, summary report, InfraNodus competitor weaknesses. So I have the file open here, and then I can open the extension of InfraNodus here, and it's going to do the same thing. It's going to take that file. If I choose here, so I have to choose here that I want to analyze final report. I'm going to choose final report. It will analyze the report, and here I have the analysis of the report itself as a network, and then I can apply the same sort of workflow as I showed you in the main version of InfraNodus. I can look at the main topics. So for example, text insights is one of the weaknesses of all those tools, that they don't provide them. Competitor analysis, this relates to Manus analyzing the competition. Data modeling, this is another weakness, focusing on the different tools. Qualitative analysis and also the user support, accessibility and user experience. So for example, if I focus on user experience, I can then ask InfraNodus to generate a summary of this topic here. And it's probably going to tell me that all of those tools, they have a steep learning curves, and it might not suit users who just want to get insights. It's an exploratory tool and it's hard to learn, and this is where InfraNodus could be helpful, for instance. So you see here it says that I could leverage InfraNodus' strength in generating networks and integrating qualitative data without the need for upfront modeling. So that's exactly what we got from the main version, but now we're getting it through the extension. And also what you can do is to select the topic and then generate an idea. And what InfraNodus does is that it first generates a question based on this topic and then it tries to respond that question. So it's a really good way to also ideate and to brainstorm on what Manus is giving you out, right? And here again, you have this advantage of focusing on a very specific aspect and getting really quick responses from this document. So you don't have to read the whole thing, but you can kind of like point the attention of AI to the specific parts that you find interesting. And finally, also what I like in InfraNodus is that you can analyze the gaps. So for example, I ask it to identify some gap. Maybe, let's see here, something that I find interesting. Let's see here, perhaps text insights accessibility. Okay, so I found this gap and then I can ask it to generate a question that would bridge this gap. So this is really good for researching how you could come into the market with something new, right? So for example, here, the question that it generates is how can integrating web-based text-to-network generation tools in desktop applications like YED and Gephi enhance accessibility and foster more intuitive insights from unstructured data. So that's quite a nice idea because it's almost like a content idea that I could use to promote InfraNodus. I could say that this is an important task that you have to do. This is how those tools cannot really do that. And this is how InfraNodus could be helpful for that. And if I want, I can send it to chat inside InfraNodus, make sure I focus on the context. So that means it's going to use this document to answer that question. And then it's going to generate a response for me that will address this question and maybe give me some content ideas or product ideas that I can use and implement into my own tool. So this is how you can combine Manus and InfraNodus. I think it's a pretty useful workflow. I use it a lot myself for ideation and for brainstorming. I hope that you find it useful too. Please let me know in the comments of the video how you use Manus as well, if you know about it, and what's your favorite workflows. And maybe we record another video where we also showcase some other use cases. Thank you very much, and I hope to see you soon.